Now the third case is you have to find the median for continuous frequency distribution. So in this case, the class corresponding to cumulative frequency just greater than n by 2 is called the median class, and the value of median is obtained by the following formula. I am just writing here. Median is denoted like MD is equal to L plus H by F n by 2 minus c. Now you have to write where L is the lower limit of median class, f is the frequency of median class, h is the width of median class, c is the cumulative frequency preceding the median class, and capital N is our sum of all the frequencies here, where I is going from 1 to n. Now here you can understand, like, what is a continuous frequency distribution. When you have a data set with corresponding class intervals, you can say this is the continuous frequency distribution. Now there is a remark on the given median formula. The median formula can be used for the continuous classes without any gaps, that is exclusive type. I will discuss what is the exclusive type later. So if we are given a frequency distribution in which classes are inclusive type, that is if there is any gap between the intervals, class interval, then it must be converted into a continuous exclusive type. I am just going to discuss what is exclusive and inclusive type. Now I am discussing what is inclusive type classification. Let there is a class interval is given like 0 to 9, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, 30 to 39, and corresponding frequencies are given here. In the first class interval, this is the first class interval. So here 0 as well as 9 is included in the class interval. So it is our inclusive type classification. For the second observation, here 10 as well as 19 are included in the class interval. So this is the inclusive type classification. So clearly you can write, if lower and upper limits included in class interval, so the data is inclusive type classification. This implies inclusive type classification. Now what is the exclusive type classification? Suppose this is the class interval is given like 0 to 5, then 5 to 10, then 10 to 15, then 15 to 20. Suppose the corresponding frequency is given 8, 9, 4, 3. So what we are looking here for the class interval 0 to 5, 0 2, 4 is included here, but not 5. Again, for the second observation, second class interval is 5 to 10. Here, 5 to 9 is included, not 10. So what we are looking here, that is the upper limit is excluded at each interval. So this type of classification is exclusive type classification, because we are just taking a gap of the upper limit at each class interval. That's why it is called exclusive. Now we will discuss how to change inclusive type classification to exclusive type classification. because we need exclusive type of classification for calculating the value of median. Now we will discuss how to convert inclusive data set to exclusive. Suppose it is given like class interval is 0 to 9 and corresponding value is 2 in the frequency. Here the lower limit will be changed like L minus D by 2, where L is the lower limit of the inclusive data set, and the upper limit will be in this case U plus D by 2, where U is the upper limit of the inclusive data set. You can write L is the lower limit of inclusive data set of a class interval, and U is equal to upper limit of inclusive data set of a class interval. Now here, what is D? D is equal to difference between upper and next lower limit. So if you have to calculate the D value for this case, so what will be equal to? It is the difference between upper and next lower limit. So suppose I am just taking the first class interval. So what is the upper limit here? It is 9. And what is the just next lower limit? It is equal to 10. So because we have to take difference, so you have to take mod sign. So it will be equal to minus 1 and it will be equal to 1 here. So the D value for this case is equal to 1. Now we will prepare a table corresponding to this inclusive data set, which will be converted into exclusive. The first class interval was 0 to 9, so lower limit will be equal to 0 minus D value is 1 here, so it will be 1 by 2, so it will become minus 0.5. Now what will be the upper limit value? It will be equal to 9 plus 1 by 2, which is equal to 9 plus 0.5, which is 9.5 for the first class interval. So it will become minus 0.5 to 9.5, and corresponding frequency will be as it is. Now again for the class interval 10 to 19, what we have, lower limit value is equal to 10 minus 0.5, which is equal to 9.5, and what will be the upper limit will be 19 plus 0.5, which is equal to 19.5. So corresponding value you can write down. Similarly, it will be equal to 9.5 to 19.5, and frequency value will be as it is. It will become 19.5 to 29.5. Now the last value will be 29.5 to 39.5, and the corresponding frequencies value is as it is. So this is the conversion of the data set which is given in inclusive. Why we convert here the inclusive data set into exclusive? Because we need the exclusive data set only to calculate the value of median. You have to just remember.